Taylor, you once again got the highest in the class for your test, while the rest of your miserable specimens couldn't even manage 60%.
Well, what do you expect, sir? She's like the biggest nerd in the whole school.
They be smart, but they sure are clumsy.
Don't worry, Ella. They're a bunch of jerks.
No, Auntie Siwe. I'm the freak, the outcast. Just leave me alone.
Don't worry. Come with me, and I'll make it all go away.
Doctors, today we're going to write a 500-word descriptive essay.
Hey, Ella, join me at court call at 2 o'clock and don't be late. Here, try this. It's really good.
What is that? Drugs? No, I won't take it. Sorry, I...
Relax. This is only going to help you. If you don't take your chance at popularity, it is going to go down the drain.
Seen you for so long, man, and oh my word, you look terrible.
Well, what's it to you?
I'm worried about you, man. You've been acting so weird lately, keeping secrets from me, and we don't even spend any time together. Please, just talk to me.
Sorry, I've got better things to do, places to be, and got no time for dweebs like you.
Now keep quiet, everyone. I'm going to hand out your test results. Ella, what happened? Your marks are steadily dropping. You better shape up, girlie. Doing in the quad. Eddie, please go and fetch her.
Hey,
Ella? 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 Ella?
As I was drifting through life and death, I heard the familiar voice, so far, yet so close. I realized that the coming of age isn't about how popular you are or about which drugs you can handle. It's about the true friends who are there to support you, no matter what. But most of all, it's about life.